Hey friends, how would you like to avoid cold starts when updating your production apps or use real production traffic to run experiments without impacting all of your customers? You can have all that and more with Azure App Service deployment slots and testing in production. Byron Tardif is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here to talk about one of my favorite things, Azure App Service. How's it going, Byron?
It's going good. Thanks for having me, Scott.
Yeah, man. I've actually been using this, so I'm excited to see some of the new improvements and stuff that you've got to show me.
Cool. So, yeah, we're going to talk about deployment slots and how you use them with testing in production. And this demo is a little bit more complicated than what I usually do.
Good.
So let's see. Let's hopefully everything goes as planned.
All right.
So I have this app that I have set up beforehand. And what I did here is just a very simple app where I have aggregated some of the videos that we've done in the past.
Oh, cool.
So if this loads, we'll see all of the different app service related videos that we have. And we have a little bit of the Azure Friday logo. Mm-hmm. And that's about it. Very simple. And the other thing that I have done is I have prepared a staging slot. For those people that are not familiar with staging slots, this is a feature of App Service that lets you create basically like a sister site of your app. Mm. And this is where we recommend people do all of the deployments. Mm-hmm. So when you're changing codes, you don't want to affect live traffic in production. You want to do all of your tests here. And then once you're confident with it, then you can put it into production. So right now, if we take a look at that app, we'll see that it has basically exactly the same. Mm-hmm. The only way that you can distinguish this right now is if you go look at the URL. So here we have Azure Friday dash stage. And if I switch over to the other one, it's just the naked Azure Friday domain.
So it's usually the, you know, whatever dot azurewebsites.net, and you add hyphen and then the name of the slot.
The name of the slot.
And you said stage. Mine says staging. It could be development, testing, production, whatever.
You name it, whatever you want. Mm. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make them look a little bit different.
Okay.
So here I'm going to show another feature that we don't usually talk about for Deployment Center, and that is the ability to move forward and backwards in your commits. Mm. So you see here, this is basically deployed from source code that I have in GitHub. Mm-hmm. And what I have here is I'm pointing to this commit, which is not the latest. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the logs and go to redeploy. So this is basically going to move the pointer from this commit to the latest commit. And it will automatically move the bits forwards. One of the things that you can do is right now I'm moving forward, but you can always move back.
You know, that's a really, really important thing that I like that you pointed out that it doesn't get talked about a lot, because mm-hmm. this is a super useful feature, because you'll find yourself accidentally putting something into staging or production, and your first impression might be, oh, I need to go and put in a commit right away mm-hmm. to move forward to fix that. That's an important thing to do, but ultimately you could get into Azure and just back out. It's effectively
exactly.
Control Z.
Exactly, on your deployment.
On your deployment, which is huge. And then later, take your time and fix your commits.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
So what I'm going to do now is I'm back into the staging slot, and I'm going to reload. And now we have a little bit different version of the code. Mm-hmm. So now I have all of these Twitter followers, and you know, here's where I see my life goal to one of these days not be a rounding number compared to your Twitter followers. So now the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go into configuration, because okay. this is another important thing to call out. You can have different versions of your code, and you can also have different versions of your configuration.
Yes.
So in this case, I'm going to edit multiple settings. So I'm going to use Advanced Editor. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to remove that underscores.
And I noticed there, when you were in that JSON, it says mm-hmm. slot setting true.
Right. So that means that this is a setting that will stay with my slot, and it will not move to production.
Oh, OK. And you could have lots of different settings. And certainly, mm-hmm. people have rich and deep configuration.
Right.
And you can decide which ones are slot specific and don't jump when you swap, and which ones do.
Exactly. So the canonical scenario is, we sometimes have people that want to target a specific database mm-hmm. when they're doing staging, so they're not modifying production data. Mm-hmm. And you can add that decoration as well to connection strings.
Yeah.
So that's where it becomes very useful.
With my sites on both Hanselman.com and Hansel Minutes, my podcast, I use ASP.NET Core_environment. And I make the name of my staging slot match my environment so that when I'm on, you know, Hanselman-debug, mm-hmm. I'm running a debug build, or if I'm on staging, I'm using my staging features. And I can even put a watermark to indicate that I am on staging.
Exactly. So I don't know if you've ever wondered what the Azure Friday would look like green.
Constantly.
Because we're, you know, always Emerald City, right?
So ooh, that actually kind of works.
That's one of the things that I did with the environment variables is I set this to basically colorize it to green.
Okay.
And it also did another very subtle change, which is it made the logo a little bit bigger.
Okay.
So now we have things that look very different in production mm-hmm. versus stage. So the next logical step would be, well, how do I make sure that what I have in stage is working properly and it's not going to break?
Right.
One of the things that you can do is you can configure testing in production. So in order to do that, I'm going to go back into my production slot. Mm-hmm. And over here, we have this UI that is built right into the deployment slots feature. Mm-hmm. This used to be a separate feature that was in a separate menu item. So if people have used it before, this is where it lives now.
Okay.
Traditionally, what we would tell people to do is basically start with like a 1% traffic going to that slot, where you start dripping a little bit of production into that slot. But for the sake of the demo, let's go 50-50 and take a bet.
And what's so interesting about this is I can tell you that in the late 90s and in the early 2000s, we would literally fly a consultant in from the company where we bought the load balancer. You would exactly. buy a load balancer, and they would teach you how to do this kind of stuff. And now it's a series of text boxes and a button. And what this does is it puts so much power in the hands of an individual that only big companies used to have before. I mean, I'm just one person running my little blog and my podcast, and now I can do sophisticated routing and test staging into production, and then I can even write PowerShell scripts and slowly ease it to 100%.
Exactly.
It's amazing.
All of this is automatable because it's exposed through the ARM surface.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the powerful things of App Service, and that's the philosophy behind how we do things. We want to make sure that these complicated scenarios become turnkey.
Mm-hmm. Now, you just deleted a cookie, which would be an affinity cookie, right?
Right.
Sticky session cookie.
That was actually the tip mix cookie.
Hmm.
So I'll explain that in a second.
Great.
So right now, we're going to take bets. When I reload, this is my production app with a production URL.
All right.
Do you think that logo is going to be green, or is it going to be blue?
50-50
green.
Chance.
So let's reload. And you're going to see that what happened here is our tip mix cookie has a value of 83,
okay.
which is greater than 50.
Ah,
so therefore, it's going to stay in production.
That's clever.
If I delete this cookie
okay.
and reload again, we might need to do it two or three times.
There
we go.
Now, would it have stuck there? Once that cookie gets
yep.
set, because you don't want someone within the context of a single session
to dance between the two.
It's that first one. So that's why that cookie
right.
acts as a tip next and also as a kind of an affinity.
Exactly.
Okay.
If I go to my staging slot, nothing's changed here. I'm just routing traffic to it.
Ah, okay. So when you go to the staging slot with the staging URL, it's
right.
staging because that's what
right.
you asked for.
Exactly.
And testing in production doesn't change staging. It changes production.
Exactly. Now, the other thing that is important is that people sometimes have outside-in monitoring.
Hmm.
And you want people to target always production and never fall into one of these experiments.
That's a great point, because I might go and set up an alert, and that alert's telling me that production is down,
right.
but I don't need to know if staging is down.
Right. Oh, no, this is more like you're validating the HTML that comes out of production. So it's
oh,
even
okay.
a little bit more sophisticated.
Oh,
right?
That's nice.
And if there's a change there, you don't want it to trigger unintentionally because you're targeting.
And it would come off as a flaky because it would sometimes be wrong.
Exactly.
Mm.
So one of the ways to do that is I have this little dashboard set up to help me. I'm going to hit this prod URL, and I'm going to call out something that's a little bit different here.
Okay.
So you can force yourself to be routed to one of your experiments by defining this extra query string parameter.
Mm.
So right now it says XMS routing name equals self,
mm-hmm.
and this always targets production. But if I give it the name of the slot that I want to hit, so in this case I named it stage, it will route me to stage.
Okay, so self means whatever the prefix in the URL is. In this
right.
case, you could say self if you're on staging, and it would stick on staging.
Yeah, exactly.
I see, and that overrides
tip any tip rules that you have.
Okay.
So this is very useful when you're doing tests or automation, and you don't want your testing in production to interfere with that.
Okay. So then, if I were going and doing whether it be Selenium tests or other tools to go and check the actual content, and I want to ensure production, that would stay there. Now, once I put that URL, that query string in once, does that stick, or do all?
You need to include it with every request.
Okay.
Because otherwise, it falls back into the routing
the
rules
standard behavior.
And testing in production. And then one final thing that I want to show you is, let's say we've done the test, we've validated everything. So now what we want to do is we want to say, hey, what we had in staging was the right thing to do. The green icon translates to more followers or more viewers.
Yep.
But you know, maybe the logo was nicer, smaller.
Okay.
So let's go tweak some of those app settings so that they will move with your code.
Okay.
So like you called out in earlier, there were some app settings that were, sorry, I'm not in the right slot.
So we're going to, and this is a really important thing to point out, right? You're in production, you're going to switch over to staging, and then you'll notice it says now stage at the corner there.
Right.
And I catch myself sometimes as well, just double checking where I'm at. And what's nice is you've changed the feature, by the way. Testing in production only works in production. You can't accidentally do it from staging.
Exactly.
And as a user of the product, I noticed that and I found it very helpful.
Yeah, we don't want people basically going on routing rule loops.
Indeed.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, yes, the color is something that we want promoted into production. So I'm going to unpin it from stage.
All right.
But the layout, we want to keep the layout with the smaller logo.
Right. We're still testing that feature.
Yeah. Or we're not satisfied with it. We might want to tweak it.
Okay.
So I'll save that, make sure those changes are applied. And then now at this point, I'm ready to perform a swap operation.
Okay.
So the swap operation is basically what promotes staging or whatever slot you want to call it, into production. And we do that through DNS. So there's no redeployment, there's no changing of the bits. And this is important because we can keep any active session going to the bits that they were using as it transitions into staging.
So because there's that affinity cookie, anyone who's in the middle of work are not going to notice this change.
Exactly.
That's cool.
And any new connections can come into the new bits, but now in the production slot. So to do that, I'm going to go over here to overview, start a swap.
I love this new UI. The new UI on swap makes it really, really clear what's happening.
Yeah, we put a lot of work to make sure that it was very clear what direction things were moving and what was going to happen once you swapped. So you can see that there's changes. Now we're going to have the color be promoted.
And it points out the old value versus the new value, and it makes it really, really clear. And it gives you a moment there to validate everything to make sure that you don't make any mistakes.
So this is going to take a couple seconds while we do the DNS trickery. Sometimes we can start hitting it earlier, even before the UI is done.
And while that's happening, I want to point out that you have this feature. If you're using App Service, this isn't a thing you need to upgrade to. I've got a basic. I've got this ability. If you have a feature of apps, if you have a version of App Service that supports slots, you have testing in production, correct?
Exactly. And this works both on Windows or Linux. It also works for our Docker-based offering as well.
Really?
So it's across the board, which goes back and forth with the philosophy of App Service, which is we build it for everybody.
Right. Yeah, so you have this feature now, and I'm actually going and deploying into GitHub. Then I build on Azure DevOps. I deploy to staging. I validate, and then I hit swap. And again, that's big company sophistication.
Right.
And I'm one person.
Right. It's people living the DevOps dream, right?
Oh, yeah. It really is.
So here we go. Now we have production.
With the new green logo, but
the
older
green logo,
size.
But the smaller size.
Fantastic. Testing in production, swapping. This is something that you have right now. I would encourage everyone who's using App Service to get on board and check this out and really think about how it can affect your workload. All right, I am learning all about the great new features and fun stuff that you can do with Azure App Service today on Azure Friday.